When these shoes were new, it was how do you do? It was whiskey and telling your tale. When my shirt was clean, I was there to be seen. I had clear eyes and my sight never failed. And all of my brothers that I've met on the way, they were drinking by night, they were drinking by day. Now restore to my eyes what was clear and was bright, and take me out drinking tonight. Whoa, take me out drinking tonight. Now bluebells and matches and stains on the table, and the sweet smell of the luscious woodbine. Well, Mr. McEwen, you will be my ruin. I said, but I don't really mind. And all of my brothers that I've met on the way, they were drinking by night, they were drinking by day. Now restore to my eyes what was clear and was bright, and take me out drinking tonight. Whoa, take me out drinking tonight. Left is heavy and the other is light. Well, if it's left up to you, girl, I know what you'll do. You'll take me out drinking tonight. Whoa, take me out drinking tonight. And all of my brothers that I've met on the way, they were drinking by night, they were drinking by day. Now restore to my eyes what was clear and was bright, and take me out drinking tonight. Whoa, take me out drinking tonight.
Hey folks, we're back.
Oh,
can't believe it's been a whole week since last time. What's going on?
The week has just flown by, right? And the last 3 hours has flown by as well. And I've got to tell you, we've spent all day trying to get everything sorted. And at like the 11th hour, about, I don't know, half an hour ago, we discovered that nothing that we'd worked out was working. But we know what it is. So I think I'm going to start every week by saying this. Next
just
week,
have me breakfast.
It's going to be brilliant.
Ready
next
to
week.
Go.
Mark's just had his mixed grilled breakfast out of tin. And
yeah, time's all gone weird, hasn't it?
Time's really very strange. Anyway, it is so good to hear you, to see your names. Because obviously we know that, you know, you tell us that you're going to tune in, but a bit like Acoustic Bliss, but in a different way. We don't know whether anybody's going to be online when we click on. And I've got to tell you that it is actually much harder work than doing Acoustic Bliss, doing this thing for tonight. And it's I can't even begin to describe to you. Anyway, I won't. But it's made me realise how much, I said this last week about how much stuff we've got, but also I'm going to have to go through some every day, right? And I'm going to have to, you know, pick my highlights. And also we've got issues, unfortunately, modern technology. We've only been streaming 5 years, but the stuff that we streamed even maybe 3 or 4 years ago, it's a lot harder to upload now. The things that we've done in more recent past are instant. Anyway, you don't want to know about this, so welcome. I can't read the comments and talk to you with my glasses on at the same time, so we'll get the comments in between. But the good news is that I did manage to salvage some things from today, and because I couldn't sort some things out last week, I'm just yada yada yada, apology, but it is like that. So anyway, we've had our tea, it's just gone dark, and we're ready. And I've had so much fun looking through the archives. It's actually a life's work.
Check this out, folks. Look, got time codes.
Don't. Surprise. Element
they can't read that. I'm just showing them we've got time codes.
Yes, I've got time codes.
It's going to be smooth tonight. Carol's been working all day on time codes. So if it goes wrong tonight, it's probably my fault.
Well, and got my... I was saying it's cherry perry, but it's actually called very cherry perry.
Just tell me when to start it then.
Right, well, I've got also worked out what the kind of general plan is for the next few weeks as well. Hopefully it won't be for months and months, but for the next few weeks. So we're going to start always with Stevie's early session. We're going to always have a bit of a delve in Moira's archive. If we can, we'll have some Ruth recommends. We're going to have a new feature, but probably not till next week now. That's going to be Chloe's choice, because Chloe, who writes the blog, she's given me some of her favourite moments from the blog spot. And Mark might do a bit of whatever it is that he does, although he can't show you his potatoes. Well, who knows? It might be that kind of night.
I might get my potatoes out later.
Yeah, and actually there's a collection itself. Innuendos for your Acoustic Bliss. Anyway, so there's going to be a kind of format, a general format of things. It won't necessarily follow the same thing every week, but I've got a kind of picture in my head. So next week it's going to be better. It'll be even better next week. So
got
let's
two
start.
Cameras, look.
I don't know if Stevie's watching. I hope you're all right, Stevie. Sending you some love. And Stevie's early session, as you know, we never actually got round to getting a lead long enough and another camera to film the early session. So Stevie's early session is hit some of his choices and some of the things that the kind of thing that would have happened earlier on in the evening. So my first clip is for Stevie's early session. So enjoy. I'm going to message you.
Any song which is going to dedicate to Mr. James Frew, who's sitting up the front there.
Sorting up the bar. Aye, we see him.
Right. No, this is the back, that's the front.
Very open to interpretation. Subtle.
He's using words like transpose. See these people with degrees in music? Just get over yourself, John. Song called The Contender by Jimmy McCarthy. When I was young and I was in my day, I could steal what woman's heart there was away. I could sing into the morning, song a blazing to the dawning, long before I was the man you see today. I was born beneath the star, promised all, could have lived my life God, but the wheel of fortune took me from the highest point she shook me, By the bottle live, by the bottle I shall fall. There in the mirror on the wall, I see the dream is fading. From the contender to the brawl, ring the matador in the rain. And when I die, I'll die a drunk down on the street. You can count me out to ten in clear defeat. Wrap the starry cloud on me. Let the piper's air is on me. There I rest until the Lord will love I be. Paul's going to join us for a wee bit.
Smooth.
Now, there are several people I already need to have words with.
Cheers, folks.
One is Jim Frew. We'll see you later, Jim Frew. We'll get you. And Peter Pollock, right, saying if we ever go high-tech and professional, he's out of here, right? I don't know what you mean. We are high-tech and highly professional. We try, that's all I can say.
I'll look for the next clip, shall I?
Yes, and so you're now on to that one. So, so it will, obviously, like most things that we do, by the time we're all out of lockdown,
God, this is hard
this
work,
will be
man.
Perfect. It is hard work. Hey, anyway, it's lovely. There is such a cross-section of people online tonight, and we're going to, hopefully, because we've got this bit a bit better under control, we can answer the questions, you know, and join in with you a bit more, because last week it was such chaos, we hardly interacted with you. But honestly, it is so much fun to just have contact with other humans, because Mark and I have spent a lot of time on our own together. I think we're quite lucky in that respect, because we've worked together for a long time, and we've worked from home, so it's, in some respects there's no difference there. But I think it's the fact that we have to, that makes a bit of a difference. So, but we're not going to use our Thursday nights as therapy, are we, Mark?
Not there yet. Keep talking, Carol.
So we've got a selection of stuff, and what I had wanted to do, but we'll come on to that, is I wanted to sort of show glimpses into some of the past, because you see, all of the people that I've seen online, we've known you at various points in our lives. Some of you right from the beginning of Bliss, and some of you more recently, and some in between. But it's really fascinating seeing all of us in various shapes and forms, it just the time goes so quickly, doesn't it? That you don't realise that actually, you know, I've been looking at bits of film today which are sort of 12 years old, and some even older. So it's like, you know, it's an amazing thing. And it was when Duffy put the picture up of himself when he was a boy, and said, this is the only picture, I never know whether to believe Duffy exactly, but this is the only picture of me when I was a kid, and thinking how different the world is now, you know, everything's on film. And so our very early days, there's some huge gaps. But anyway, we have photographs, we have all sorts. So we're going to pull it together. I found some hilarious things, and we'll come to that. We're also going to have Carol's Happy Place at some point. And blah, 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 blah. So are we ready, Mark?
We'll be ready in 10 seconds.
So I had a list of things that I've left at home. I might go and get that when I go outside. So are you all right? How is it in the rest of the world, wherever you are? Strange, hey? I nearly said Nespa then, but I don't know what that was.
Nepa.
Nespa.
Nepa.
Enculé. Cherry Perry, and not having to drive. I had a bit of a hangover last Friday.
Right, I think I'm ready.
So I wasn't liking that very much. Anyway, so we're still, if you like, we're still in the early session. And you know, Stevie and the good old boys, and the early session, you know, starts about 7:30-ish and goes through till at 10 normally. And
I'm going to check my potatoes are all right.
You've had a lot of requests.
I'm not showing them out though.
People are interested in your potatoes.
Blow your carrots off.
Right. So we're gonna continue with the early session for a little bit. And so here's the thing. Now this is actually from my birthday a couple of years ago.
Somebody's birthday.
It was my birthday.
Is it somebody's birthday?
It was my birthday. I genuinely thought I'd got away with it and that nobody knew. Right.
Yeah, I walked into my mum's house once and there was some birthday cards on the sideboard, and I said, is it somebody's birthday? And my mum said, my mum said, yeah, it's mine. Gotta start that again, folks.
It's still playing.
Yeah, but there's no audio. They can't hear it.
Ah, okay. Apparently you can't hear that. There we are, Peter. Another reason to stay. Thoroughly professional.
Should we switch the sound on?
I don't know where to look anymore. I don't know which thing to look at. Oh. Anyway, seriously.
We'll try it again with the sound on, folks.
This is... Sorry.
I met my love by the gasworks wall. Dreamed a dream by the old canal. I kissed my girl by the factory wall. Dirty old town, dirty old town. The clouds are gray. Cats are prowling on the beam. Springs a girl from the streets at night. Dirty old town, dirty old town.
Well done, Lee.
Thank you very much.
He passed the Wolfie test. He's still on the stage and he didn't lick his backside.
It's not the licking I'm worried about. One more, guys.
I hear the trainer coming, it's rolling round the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when, but I'm stuck on the floor. Time keeps dragging on, and that train it keeps a rolling right on to San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mother told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot and me know just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. I bet there's folks eating in a fancy dining car. They'll be drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. But I know I had it coming, I know I can be free. But those people keep a moving, and that's what tortures me.
Now, I wish I'd never mentioned potatoes, frankly, or carrots. Anyway, so Duffy's in. Well done. We were a bit slightly worried about you. Will you stop zooming in?
No.
Oh, God, honestly.
Trying
seriously.
Get myself off the screen.
Moira's in as well. Oh, and Tracy.
Hey,
hello,
Moira.
Tracy. And John Ben and Jeff Ellis.
Hey, John Ben.
And Dave Johnson and Laura. Get good cheese in. And any...
and Mike Abbott, by the way. Thank you, Mike.
And you're hilarious, by the way.
You're a star.
Absolutely hilarious. And we've got Steve Duncan from Newton Hill. Hello, Steve, Jonathan, and Kirsty watching. Hello, Kirsty. We haven't met you yet, but hello, hello, hello. We feel like we know you. Are you in the pub? You in your pub? At the bar. And is this not the weirdest thing? Anyway, so
I'm not doing this one.
Say not sober. That's Ruth. Ooh, you're not sober. She's insane.
Well, I don't know about that, Ruth, anyway. See,
now I'm super conscious of the challenge that Peter Pollock has said that he won't be coming anymore if we are thoroughly professional and high tech, right? So I'm don't know what to do, because if I try to be thoroughly professional and high tech, then Peter Pollock will abandon us. It's my mind's in meltdown. Do we know what we're doing?
I'm almost ready.
Are you? Right, okay. So now I had an elaborate plan. Honestly, I had little pics here and there and everywhere. I've made a note of them, so I know where they are, and I will try and recall them. I'll try and get them for next week. But because we had this problem, it's very boring, but it's to do with uploading it into the studio. We can't just play it off any old... We can't even play it off Mark's laptop, but it has to be loaded up into the studio. And so, quite a few of the things that I wanted, we couldn't sort out. We will be able to sort them out. We need to, because we will. Peter, we will. But so in the meantime, what we're doing is I'm picking from things that we could upload, all right? But we've got, it doesn't matter, I could literally stick a pin in things, and apart from me gabbing and some of the, you know, less some of the eventful times, we could literally, you know, do a random thing and we'd have something to play. But anyway,
do you remember the time when the woman shat herself at the bar? Then were the days.
Those were the days. Of... No, they probably the days, don't remember they, that. Eh? Doing me.
Duffy will remember that.
Duffy will remember that. And Lynn. I don't know if Lynn met Megan and Lynn watching. That was
salubrious bar.
That was, oh no. But the thing is, the thing about the pub is that it. I mean, generally speaking, you know,
yeah,
quite genteel. We didn't have. We had not much bother, and it certainly didn't happen every week that somebody did a poo.
At the bar.
At the bar, whilst they were ordering a drink. But it did happen once. That's definitely the case. And maybe when we write the Acoustic Bliss memoirs, that
was my favourite night.
Is that, was that your favourite night? There's been a few, and there's a few on camera as well. But the thing is, finding those moments, you know, finding the guy opening his raincoat to. Was that Flew the Arrow, I think?
What?
The guy who opened his... Anyway, so we're not
going
to go...
We had a flasher.
Yeah.
I didn't see that. I missed that.
Yes. Thing. And it's like, that's on
I
film.
Missed quite a lot.
Yes.
Because I'm staring at my bloody screens.
Yeah.
So I missed that.
Yeah.
So a guy came in and flashed. Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Wasn't the same night, was it?
No, and then he... Oh, I hope not. And then he went outside and took the rest of his clothes. Honestly, so... But if you've not been to the pub before, if you're watching for the first time, or you know, you've not met us before, the pub's actually... It's lovely. You know, it is on a Thursday night when we do Bliss. It's the sort of pub that, you know, women of all ages could just go in on their own and there'd be no bother. And you just... Like any public place, you get the odd troublesome person. Usually Mark, actually. What are you laughing at? Stop thinking of all the things. Anyway, so... So, what I've got is we're going to have to play more things from the same night rather than flicking through the ages, as if you like. So this is another bit of film from the same night, but I've chosen particular songs that I like and things. And anyway, so we're still kind of in Stevie's early session, but if you know, like, the early session then transmutes into the late show. It swaps from the late. It swaps. I'm going to get good at this, though, Peter. I'm going to get good at it.
Smooth.
And then you can say signing off. Adios.
You can go nice, right, as you point at the other camera.
Yeah, right.
Nice. Like that. Should we play the clip?
Forgotten. Yeah.
Right, playing the clip, folks. See you in. Well, actually, I don't know when this clip ends. You'll have to tell me.
John Ben just said, "Did the flash pen is?" But no. No, he literally came in a raincoat. I'm not even joking. Came in a raincoat. I'll find the clip. I can't remember exactly what it is. And then he went outside and took the rest of his clothes off in the bus stop. So all the smokers, Duffy probably remember this.
Was
it
cold?
All the smokers were outside. And yeah. Anyway, there aren't, but what I'm saying is there aren't many nights like that. It's not every week.
That was a quiet night.
That was a quiet. Anyway, so.
Howling with Madness, Duffy says, isn't it? Howling with Madness. Like One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest, but with music. So
play.
I'm going to start this clip, and then you're going to have to tell me when to stop it.
Okay.
Because I don't know.
Right, well.
You only gave me a start point for this one. See you in a bit.
Thank you. Take the body to the river, lay it down upon its way. Let the floating to forever. Isn't this a glorious day? If it's the end, it's not the only end. Let it begin, let it unfold again. I wish that I fit my clothes better. Wish that I had more to say. Before things can get much better, gonna have to face today. If it's the end, it's not the only end. Let it begin, let it unfold again. Love is like a coat of mirrors for your lover to embrace. As you grow, she'll know you better. You can throw that coat away. And if it's the end, it's not the only end. If it's the end, it's not the only end. If it's the end, it's not the only end. Let it begin, let it unfold again.
John Duffy, Carol. Well, those are recognition of Little Big Man, who was a true gent, a lovely man, a great player, always a pleasure to be in his company. And he always, yes, he had a strong interest in horticulture. Another one, lucky man, did you say? Aye.
He had a white horse.
So this is Brian. He also knew. Thanks, Mr. Duffy.
Brian, the bridge troll.
Oh,
horse country, that's king. Bob is on her land, Lord.
Those of you who don't know Jerry O'Hagan is a fantastic, well, you can hear him, sax player, but it's what he does as well as he runs, I think he's a plumber as well as being a fantastic saxophonist. He's got an amazing collection of beautiful saxes of different sizes, and he's in lots of bands, not surprisingly. So if, I don't know if Jerry's watching, but what a lovely thing. I love singing on that one. If you think, right, well, you look ridiculous that day, well, it was my birthday, and there are many beautiful reasons to be happy.
What a lucky man.
What a lucky man. So,
look at the delay, man.
Right, so the delay's quite big, delay, which is confusing for us. I don't think that's what it...
Everything's gone a bit mental.
So let me tell you about our next little clip. So this next performer is someone who claims not to be a performer at all. Although we know lots of those, don't we? And this person, Mark and I met quite a long time ago. There's more than one person that I've said this to. We were in a bar playing and there was hardly anybody in. There's a theme there, isn't there?
Yeah.
And
was
this
that
person...
Was before or after we played?
Before, during and after. I don't even know why. What it was a weird... I don't know. I can't remember what day it was. But it was. We were actually in the Courtyard bar, those of you who remember the Courtyard, when it first started doing music. And strange wee place to play because it was right by the men's toilets, so you had to play slightly to the right of the pathway, or the left if you're coming up of to the toilet. And sometimes, as you know, I sing with my eyes shut, and so sometimes I would literally open my eyes when I was doing a top note and there'd be a man going past to the bogs, or you'd see people looking because there was a man behind you trying to wait, you know, guess when he could get by. Anyway, we were in there, and I mean, whether there's one or a million people, we play the same, and we like playing. So anyway, this man, because it is a man, was at the back with a woman who's also watching. The pair of them were in, and at the end, as we were leaving, Jim Frew said, that was wonderful, thank you. Words to that effect, anyway. And, I think he actually said, I'd have paid to see that, or something like that. And he was glad that he'd come out, and blah, blah, blah. So I think it might have been a Sunday night. Anyway, Jim, so that's how we first met him. And then he started coming to, they both started coming to the firehouse. And he's sort of, he's a part of Bliss. And he does his own, he does some amazing things. He's done a fantastic charity thing with the Dodgy Jumpers. And anyway, he's not a musician, apparently. But hey, we're going to prove him wrong. I really like Jim's voice, and I like what he does. So,
I hope this works.
Jim and Tracy, with virtual hugs to you. It will work.
Yeah, I hope I haven't cocked this one up. Hang on.
I gave him the signature code, so he couldn't possibly cock up, could he, folks?
I was going to say something really good.
You're going to change.
Carol, we did something for the first time.
See, I'm looking at that screen again, and you told me, look at that screen. What did we do?
Look at that one.
No, no, but it's not there, is it? I'm looking at that one so people can see up my nose.
Oh, you've put me off now. We've got no... They can't hear us talking anyway.
Why?
I've got to turn the audio on. Oops. What was
you're
on about?
You're joking. After all that, I said all that about Jim and it was all...
I don't know.
Jim!
No, I think they could hear it. I think
hello,
it was just
Chloe.
A bit quiet.
Oh, did you hear any of what I said about Jim?
The sound is very low, they said. Right, we fixed it. User error.
Peter Pollock's calling for a piper. Maris.
Bloody rubbish.
Good one.
Can't beat.
Anyway, I told the whole story about Jim Frew then. For God's sake,
tell it again.
No. Jim
Frew. No, they probably heard it anyway. It was just a bit low, Carol.
Did you hear it? Right, can somebody message?
F's
did
in
you
the
hear,
chat, folks.
Did you hear what I was saying about Jim Frew? Did anybody hear about Jim Frew? So
Carol,
Jim Frew.
Delay.
Oh, right, Jim Frew. Put the camera on my face.
Tell it, Carol.
Right. What I was saying was, Jim Frew, he says he's not a musician. Ha ha. Right. Love watching him. Love his voice. He's a performer. Right. And Jim and Tracy, we met them at the Courtyard Bar. That's what I was saying. It was a beautiful story. Right. But anyway, Jim and Tracy, but thank you for all the support you've given us. Because there is nothing more. What's good for the soul when you play in a quite an empty bar to, as you leave, to someone to say that was whatever they say, something good.
I'm
and
going
that's
for
so
a refill.
Nice. Thank you. So hopefully you heard that. Jim. He's done it again.
Done it again.
Jim.
It's coming.
Peter,
we'll try that again.
We're a long way away from you leaving, Peter. Don't worry. Your Thursday nights are safe.
I got offered a job on the BBC.
Wasn't that Channel 4?
No, that would never happen to you.
No.
Should we try this again, then?
Look, my hair's like wild and bad. Right, please, come
your
on.
Hair. Right. Sorry, folks. We're going to try this again. Are we ready?
Come on, Jim Frew! Dun dun dun!
Well, hello there. My husband won't. How am I doing? Well, I guess I'm doing fine. So long now, but it seems it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? How's your new told him love him till the end of time. Well, that's the same thing that you told me. Seems like only yesterday. When it's your birthday, seems like time slips away. Isn't it funny how time slips away? Sing two songs. I was wanting to do it. Funny how time slips away, and I'll do one of my own, and it's called No, My Father Once Told Me. It's called. Oh, brilliant. When I was young, nobody could hold me. My father told me. Your day will come, but then he knew nothing, like when my life was before me, like when all my future had only begun. For the world, it has no care when you are young. My father once told me, your day will come. I would find my own way, make my own road, find the right from the wrong way, and carry my own load. A dashing young buck, when life was so sweet, making my own love. With the world at my feet, the world has no care when you are young. My father once told me, your day will come. I made a family, forever they be mine. In the passing years then, I never counted the time. And they say life happens when you're making plans. And like the sands of time, I suppose life can just slip through your hands. The world is no care when you are young. My father once told me, family they've flown out, they're making me wrong. I sit here alone now, watching on me. And it's you, when you're older, you wonder where did it go. Hello, when you're older, somehow you just see it. The world has no care when you are young. My father once told me, your day will come. My father once told me, your day. Thank you. I was only doing that for carols, but I'll do one more. One more.
Oh. Right, well, I'm not quite sure why
Carol didn't let him do one more some reason.
No, but maybe we'll get back to that. Right, because I don't need to do that. I chose, I chose my list when things weren't quite, when I thought things were going to be different. So. Now, some of you, by the way, two things, right? Peter Pollock, if there was going to be an award for potato jokes and puns and innuendo, Peter's winning it at the moment.
Yeah, sacks of potatoes is the winner.
That's good. Well, so far we are. Sacks of potatoes. Hey, listen, we're only an hour in, so. Duffy, you can't ask, brilliant. You can't do requests. We're not, you know, we're not able to do that yet.
You can do requests, but it might have to wait till next week.
Yeah,
well, if you're lucky.
So obviously, request something, I can look for it. One day, I'll be able to just plug something in, and it'll attach to my brain, and I'll be able to upload my thoughts directly to you all, and you won't even need to watch. There's a scary thought, anyway. So, but no requests. And then the other thing was, he's not tonight for the Zip story. We've talked about his gonads far too much already, thank you very much. So that's a no. Yeah, okay, so
I'm still not wearing any pants.
my nostrils flowing, that's when it's really, when it's really stressful. So I've forgotten what. Right, okay, I know what.
Carol, we did something this week for the first time ever. We've never done before. Do you remember what it was? Do you remember what it was? We did something that we've never done before this week.
We stood by a pile of pallets. Well, I've never done it. In the B&Q car park.
You might have done
it. I've never done that before.
can you remember what it was? We'll see if anybody can guess what it was.
Right, including me. Right. Yeah. Okay, I'll find out what it is after this. Okay, so Moira Turner. Now, sorry, firstly, thank you, Jim Free. So what I was saying at the beginning was, you know, it's really good to have people paying you compliments when you're the only people in the bar, and which you were that night. And and we, as you can see from the comments, we love it when you play and sing, so thank you. And so the next thing that we're going to play is Moira. I asked Moira, as you all know, Moira is the gallery queen, and actually, apart from the fact that she took, you know, most of the pictures, she also rescued a huge amount from Facebook when they decided that we didn't deserve a page some years ago, and they just closed the account, and we lost quite a lot of stuff, and Moira managed to claw it back from various places and re-uploaded it. Thank you, Moira. And so anyway, so I asked Moira if she would, you know, go through the gallery and, you know, pick a theme or do something, and let's get some old pictures. So and so Moira's just picked themes and randomly got some pictures, and so we're going to show some of those now. And and we've gone up a, you know, Peter Pollock, get this, we've gone up a notch from last week, flicking through the pictures and getting, you know, talking over them.
Carol made a film.
Here we go. Moira's Magical Moments.
I have lost my heart in Budapest on a night in the middle of you. When the gypsy bands were at their best and the Danube was lit by the moon, someone was singing pulsatory, and I lost my heart completely. I have lost my heart in Budapest on a night in the middle of June. Heart in Budapest on a night in the middle of June, when the gypsy bands were at their best and the Danube was lit by the moon. Someone was singing, all so sweetly, and I lost my heart completely. I have lost my heart in Budapest on a night in the middle of June.
Yay! Oh, hello Mona in Canada. And she says it's snowing in Canada. Oh, lordy. It's hard. That's hard. Kind of hard to imagine now because we've... It was so beautifully warm today and still did actually feel like spring was here. Because sometimes, I don't know if you remember, sometimes
they missed
April,
the bit about it snowing in Canada.
Did you miss that bit?
Yeah, I missed that bit off because I was too slow with my knob.
He was too slow with his knob. Right, so hello, Mona. Hello, Mona. What I was saying was, it's snowing in Canada. That's what Mona was saying. And I'm saying how it has been beautifully warm here today. So... yeah, you'll be sorry you weren't here. It felt a bit like spring, and even though it's not at all normal, but sometimes in April, well, especially these next 2 weeks, the last kind of couple of weeks of April, we've had scorching weather here. In fact, we used to run a, I don't know if people remember, we used to run a build your own amp course with Barry Vise, who used to come up from London, and April, middle to the end of April was always when he used to come. And we often had, we actually had lunch in the yard at a big, you know, big tables because it was that hot. It was actually warmer outside than it was inside. And we'd get sunburned whilst we were having our dinner. So, yeah, and one day there was a guy, I don't know who it was, but he had no hair. He was a guy with a bald head. And a bird came and landed on his head. Do you remember that?
What, in the pub?
No.
What about now?
Right, see that? Did you say what in the pub? That's
I wasn't listening.
My entire day is like that. I say something and then he says something from a completely
I can hear it. Feels like it's my feet again. Sorry about this, guy.
When I saw you standing there with those hazel eyes, I couldn't help but stare, and I knew that I was a goner when you flashed your smile. I waved my white flag with honor and prepared to fall. As you said hello, I approached you cautiously, 'cause I knew that you would have the victory.
London, sang in a choir. We backed him a few times. This is called Honest Man.
Maybe there's another way around, so we can live this upside down. It's hard now for an honest man. You're sad. I am an honest man, and you're the kind who seems too beautiful and out of reach for me. I'm in, I've got you underneath my skin. I fall apart, to look away is getting hard. All goes dark.
Meg's from Canada. Meg from Canada's watching. Hello, Meg. And we've also got Sandy McFadden in. Hello, hello. So that, before I got a chance to introduce, was Amy Penman, the fantastically voiced Amy Penman. And actually, I was really, really delighted to stumble across that because Amy's actually a keyboard player. She is a classically trained singer and keyboard player. She plays piano, but she has the most incredible range. And if you've ever seen her, any of her videos or seen her live, she has, you know, she really does have the most amazing range. And that was her, she'd been writing some songs and she'd taken up strumming the guitar, and I just thought it was a really nice wee set. So thank you to Amy. And if you can look her up, Amy Penman, on Facebook, and she does all sorts of gigs, gigs and entertainment and backing for, she's done a fantastic dance track with a band that's escaped my mind. But anyway, so thank you to Amy. Right, now we're gonna try and sorry, I've just seen a comment from Sandy to Chloe about her Bliss debut. Well, apparently Chloe told me that Gordon, if you're watching Gordon, he said that we ought to play that every week. I'm a cat, you know. I said, right, the new theme tune, right? Chloe didn't really want that, but what a thing. I'm a cat, I'm in Glasgow. So now we've got an experiment, and if this goes okay, then we'll be really happy. So
it won't. We'll try.
Right, but before...
Right, Sandy.
Before you press play, right? So we've all been mentioning Sandy and how we're missing him, but Sandy, well, I mentioned this last week about him, you know, we're really proud of him, but I thought about him a lot yesterday because I was up very early, and in the early hours of the morning the news came through that John Prine had died, and of course, you know, tragic thing, and also a great loss to the songwriting world. But I then immediately thought about Sandy because actually it was Sandy that really brought John Prine's songs to my attention in a loving way, you know, because he quite often played them at Bliss. So I messaged Sandy today and asked him if he would do something for us. So we've not tried this before, but fingers crossed. Mark says it's not going to work, but that's just him all over, isn't it? So let's see if we can get it to work. So bear with us.
There might be a pitch. This might not be as smooth as it normally is, folks. Bear with us a second. I'm going to cut the audio from us and then I'll put the audio on. I'm having to patch it in from the desktop.
They don't care.
So this is Sandy coming up any minute now.
About there, right? We're back in the room now. Hey, Peter, are you proud of us? We're living up to the thing. So, is that gonna? Are you gonna give it another go?
Sorry, folks, not happening.
Do we know? We don't know what that is.
No, I've no idea.
Oh.
I can't do anything about that.
Okay, right. Oh. So, can we maybe download it? See if you can. We'll try something else because we've still got some. You know, we've got plenty of time, so we'll try and do that. Yeah, it is a little trippy. Oh, you could hear that. Yeah, it was too, and there was a whistling noise as well. So we'll try and do that. Because it's a lovely thing, and it's something that he's done today. But we've only just got it now.
It says it's going to take 7 minutes to download.
That's
so
all right.
We'll try playing it in a bit.
Well, so let's go on to the next thing, right, which is back to here.
Lordy law.
So did you like the photos? Did you like Moira's magical moments and a bit of Tipsy Gypsy?
And Amy Penman.
Yeah, I did all that.
Yeah, so, sorry. I accidentally cut Carol off in mid-flow. Don't know if you noticed.
So Tipsy Gypsy, that was a bit of them. And Gary and, I was going to say Dave then, but I meant Duffy. Yes, please. And and I thought that, well, actually, weirdly, it was exactly the right amount of time for the photos. And see, I love the old photos because obviously there's the people and there's some people in there. It's just so lovely to see their faces. Well, all of you, but, you know, a couple there that it's really precious. And then, but also the stuff in the background and the heads and the different things and the stuff in the different bars and yeah. Which actually brings me to, I'm going to say this whilst he's lining up. Where's my bits of paper? You've moved them. So I found, when I was going through some things, I found some hilarious stuff, right? And I found this, right? And I don't know if anybody remembers this competition, right? We had one of our birthday parties, we had to design a new logo and I gave everybody a picture of a T-shirt. And look, this one was by Erica, the wonderful Erica. And look, can you see? It says Acoustic Bliss. Closing down pubs since 2006. And that was a reference to the little story that I printed on the back, right? Now, I'm not going to read it all out. Maybe I'll put it up. But whilst Mark's sorting out the next thing. So in 2006, I actually learned something reading this. It says Acoustic Bliss is 8 years old today. Hard to believe, eh? In 2006, there were no open mic nights. only one jam session in Prestwick and an acoustic session in Wellies. So Paul Cairns, a super great guitar player, asked us to bring our PA on Thursday the 26th of January, are you noting this, Moira, to bar cruise on the Sandgate. It lasted 3 weeks, brackets, then closed. We moved reluctantly, it had nice sofas, to the Boroughfields Bar. It should be the Boroughfields Cafe Bar. Nobody used the internet then to get gigs, to go to gigs. I used to text everyone and make posters. That lasted nearly 5 years, brackets, then closed. We moved even more reluctantly to the firehouse. It's just temporary till the plumbing's fixed, we said, although the firehouse had sofas and pizza and coffee. By this time, over 300 different players had passed through. That lasted just over 2 years, brackets, then it closed. Are you seeing a pattern? Oh dear. But look what has happened. At least 9 regular open mics that we know of every week, live music in many bars, air-based musicians forming bands and gigging all over the damn place, and even the best small music venue in Scotland, the Basement Cafe, if you didn't know. That was Erica's wee bar, and they did. They got the NME Best Small Music Venue in Scotland award in their first year. And someone invented the internet so they can all tell us what's going on. Amazing. And what an awesomely musically gifted town. So we can be forgiven for thinking that there was plenty to do and places to go, and that bliss was everywhere in spirit. And maybe all good things have to come to an end, and perhaps the old needs to make way for the new. Because we'd, you know, the firehouse had closed and we'd stopped for a wee while, and we were upset. But many of you have had serious words with us, and we've both been quite sad. It felt like we had lost something really special that we all worked really hard to make. And this is the paragraph that got me. So then we realised we all worked hard to make something lovely, and you are still here, and we are still here. And surely we can't close every damn venue in the town. Ah. So, very prophetic. In the words of Bob Seger, so here we are, both of us lonely. Let's make it last. Let's find a way. We've got tonight. Who needs tomorrow? We've got tonight. We think we'll stay, but we'll move about a bit, spreading the risk to local businesses evenly. Fair as always. Welcome back and thanks to you all. And so that was our 8-year-old birthday message. And I love that prophetic thing. Surely we can't close every damn venue in the town. Hey, Acoustic Bliss. Closing venues since, closing pubs since 2006. Anyway, this one will go on record. This will be in the books. So, a great night in. I never even mentioned that. Welcome to a great night in, wherever you are, whatever you're watching. So next, we've got another clip. We're obviously, I say I'm limited. We're going back to the night where we were before, but this is quite a rare thing as well.
Potatoes.
This is rare, because we don't often get this man just on his own. Roll VT.
Hang on a minute. Let me just check that the audio is on.
See, do you notice Peter Pollock? My seamless introductions, and he always stuffs them up. I go, ta-da.
I just wanted to check the audio was going to play.
No, but why didn't you check it before I finished speaking? And then he says, you talk too much. You talk too much.
What do you mean about Baker Street in a school? I'll just do one wee song for Carol. I'll just hear myself. I feel lonely. Just me and my saxophone. What do you mean about Baker Street in a school somewhere?
Hey!
winding your way down in Baker Street. Light in the head and you're dead on your feet. There's another crazy day. You drink the night away and forget about everything. This city doesn't make you feel so cold. It's got so many people, but it's got no soul. And it's taken you so long. Find that you're wrong and forget about everything, yeah. You used to think that it was so easy. You used to say that it was so easy. But you're crying now. Another day and then you'll be happy. Just one more year and then you'll be happy. But you're dying now. Got that look on his face, and he'll ask you where you've been. You tell him you're seen, and we'll talk about everything, yeah. He's got this dream about buying some land. Give up the blues and the one-night stands. Then he'll settle down in a quiet little town and forget about everything, yeah. You used to think that it was so easy. You used to say that it was so easy. But you're crying now, yeah. Another year and then you'll be happy. Just one more year and then you'll be happy. But you're dying now.
So much you can do yourself with a saxophone.
day. Bit of Jerry O'Hagan, fantastic. And that was quite rare because obviously Jerry, he just turns up when he can, right? And so we never know when he's coming. He just turns up and he'll jam with, you know, he loves to jam with people because obviously it's a lot harder to be a solo act without some kind of backing. But I think that's the only time I saw him sing as well. So that was blooming brilliant. So thank you for that. Now, you might remember before we went to Jerry, we said we had a message from Sandy McFadden. And we're all missing you, Sandy. I think I said this last week, but round of applause for Sandy. 16 months off the beer, and but we, you know, that's so that obviously makes coming out to the bar not so easy, does it? But hopefully by the time we're open, you will be able to come and play with us again. Oh, geez, so what I said before was that as soon as I heard in the early hours of yesterday that John Pine had sadly died, that I thought about Sandy as well. And so we asked Sandy if he would send us a message, and here he is.
So we downloaded it. Let's hope this plays. Fingers crossed.
That's a John Morland song. Come down from your mountain, I miss your holy shouting. These days I can't make you make a sound. Take me to the times when we'd look up to the skies, climb up there and draw the thunder down. I'm forcing myself into what you've already been through, but darling, I can't help the way I feel, and you need something stronger, a drug to kill the hunger, easy awful pain of living here. And I'm the kind of love it hurts to look at, and maybe we should take it as a sign. When I'm strung out on leaving, exalting all my demons, you don't care enough for me to cry. I dreamed I'd take you with me, and you'd say you forgive me, and we'd live out some ancient easy song. Now we're out here unattended in the splendid loving remembrance. You lost a mind to even do me wrong, and I'm the kind of love it hurts to look at. But once I was enough to make you try. Now I'm underneath the rubble, trying not to feel the trouble, and you don't care enough for me to cry. So here's to hoping I can change tomorrow. You want it hard as nails cut and dry, but I beg, steal and borrow, so damn good at sorrow, and you don't care enough for me to cry.
Thank you very much.
Wow.
Well, that worked. Nice one, Sandy.
So,
totally awesome.
What? Yeah, and people are saying that they miss your voice. Yeah, we miss you. And that'll be one of the amazing things about getting out, won't it? Be to see everybody again. And I think we're gonna have to hire a big tent or something, aren't we? But thank you for that, Sandy.
Am I going to abandon this now?
Yeah, but you can't.
Can I close it down?
You might come back to it though, eh?
Well, I'll leave it open then. Because it'll eat the computer.
Look, see what.
Should we have some interaction? Has anybody guessed what it is that me and Carol did for the first time we've ever done in our lives? Or at least me. I don't know if Carol's done it before. I don't think so. I think it was the first time for Carol too.
I don't know.
It's definitely a first time for me. What do you reckon, folks? What was it?
Why? What's going on? I don't understand.
Well, I can't do everything at once. What do you want? What do you want me to do? Am I doing this or am I doing that?
I don't know. I don't know. Why are we looking? Why are we looking
well,
to one side?
Let me just
like
close all that down. Change the feckin' camera for you.
Ooh. No, it's right. Not changing because you're not on that. I'm talking about why are we not looking into the camera? Why were we looking over there?
Folks.
What were you saying? So, oh, what the hell? What are we doing?
I don't know.
No, what did we do? What have we? What
What's
have we
next?
Done? What have we done? We keep going on about this thing. What is it?
Nobody cares. We made pasta, folks.
Oh.
We made homemade pasta for the first time ever. All it is what eggs and no eggs.
Oh, look,
we used powdered eggs.
Did you steal something? Did you get your spuds cooked? Did you eat chicken for the first time? Did you plant? Listen, he's a carnivore.
I did plant purple carrots. How did you know?
Oh,
I've planted some purple carrots.
Psychic dude, we're looking at the wrong
actually,
camera.
I think that might be a euphemism.
So it's not
thinking
though,
about
is
it?
But it's not.
Planting the purple carrot.
Oh, stop.
You said that, dude. What do you like?
When I was quite small, we had this uncle and auntie that weren't our uncle and auntie, and I don't even normally say auntie either. My uncle and auntie that, and they weren't my uncle and auntie.
Let me sort the next clip.
But we used to go to their house.
Go over there and talk
twice. We used to go to their house twice a week, right, after school, and my uncle Fred, I loved him. He was such a fantastic bloke. But he used to tell the same jokes every week, and there was a series of things that he used to say, and I've all my life
gets funnier with a repetition.
Uncle Fred jokes, right? And now I live with my Uncle Fred because my partner Mark
it gets funnier every time you say it, doesn't it, folks?
He now tells Uncle Fred jokes.
I think it's funny.
Yes, and lockdown. So what are we doing anyway? Thank you to Sandy for that. That was awesome. And also it was an experiment that worked, but what a voice.
Yeah, that worked. Nice one, Sandy.
Thank you, Sandy. So that's something else we can do. So right, the next, yeah, that do that one next if that's okay.
I'm gonna try well, this one that rhymes with cat.
Yes. So our next clip is also from my birthday, because, like I say, we're limited a bit. Still got a couple of things up my sleeve, but this is a man whose birthday it was a couple of weeks ago. But when we the first night, I couldn't get to this clip because the technology stopped me. But now, thanks to modern technology and our utter techie professionalism, I'm able. Ignore that little thing. I'm able to, at the click of a finger, recall this man.
Click of a finger.
Birthday it was. And so let's celebrate his birthday of a couple of weeks ago and wish him all the well. He's in a different country, mind. He's across the water. But but we love him just the same. And hopefully he's another person
keep
that will
talking,
be
keep
more.
Talking.
Now, did you hear that? Mark told me to keep talking. Did you hear that? I'm going to write that down. What time was that? 10:47 on the April the 10th, whatever time. Yeah, Mark told me to keep talking. So anyway,
right.
Are we ready?
You're talking on this thing as well. Is that supposed to be right? Set that, yeah. Okay.
We're just going to play this clip.
Hang on. I'll switch the audio on. It's hard, this is.
Honestly, you've no idea.
See all these buttons, you have to press them all.
Right, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Right, I think that's it. Ready?
Happy birthday!
Come on. It looks like you, though.
Just press happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Anyway, if you haven't seen Pat before, he's grand. The only thing that's missing tonight is the beach. That's the only thing. I mean, there's a few people that I would like to be here as well, but frankly, apart from that, a beach would be nice, wouldn't it, if we could do this on a beach? Well, come on, do you agree with me, or are you all too pissed to say so? Oh, I'm looking at Moira there.
When I spin my body over, I spin a wheel last night. When I spin my body over, spinning wheel last night. Where Red 37 didn't dream me right. Well, I went in smiling, but I came out feeling down. Well, I went in smiling, but I came out feeling down. Well, I got me no money, I got no friends around. Well, I spent my money on a spinning wheel last night. Well, I spent my money on a spinning wheel last night. Well, Red 37 didn't dream me right. Well, high up a mountain, high up a lonesome hill. Well, I went high up a lonesome, high up a lonesome hill. Well, I need a lot of money just to pay my bill. Well, I spend my money on a spinning wheel last night. Well, I spend my money on a spinning wheel last night. Well, Red 37 didn't read me right. Pack up my bags and go. Well, the spinning wheel blew, made me pack up my bags and go. Well, I had to leave my whole town, they don't want me no more. Well, I spent my money on spinning wheel last night. Well, I spent my money on spinning wheel last night. Red 37 didn't treat me right.
There's two on there, but Pat from that stand. Couple.
crazy world. It's alright. Yeah, it's alright. I've fallen down so many times. I don't know why, don't know where, don't care less, it's all the same. I have traveled through so many towns. I don't know why, don't know where, don't care less, it's all the same. Crazy world, it's alright, yeah, it's alright. Can you hear the sound of nothing, nothing, nothing right, nothing wrong, don't care. Love is real, don't you know that life is what you feel? Well, it's alright, yeah, it's alright. How can I protect you in this crazy world? It's alright. Yeah, it's alright. How can I protect you from all the crime that's gone? Now the party's over, all the moves are gone. It's alright. Yeah, it's alright. How can I protect you with this crazy world? It's alright. It's such a crazy
one. So you just have to sing, right? That's Acoustic Bliss. That's this part of it. There's no such thing as a free lunch, right?
I have.
But we'll keep it. We'll keep it really simple, right? All you have to do. This is your bit, right? Is la 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 la. Right, nearly there. So the next bit is la 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 la. We got it. Okay, so down to you, right, try it. La 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 la. Two bits. La la la. You'll get there. Oh, love is a burning thing that tastes like fiery rain. Well, I'm bound by wild desire, while not failing the ring of fire. I fell into the burning ring of fire. Burn down, 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 please get higher. And it burns, burns, burns. Your ring's on fire. Your ring's on fire. Back to you. La la la. La la la. give up. Hey, well, the taste of love is sweet when hearts are like ours be. Well, I fell for you like a child. Oh, to play a wild. I fell into the burning ring of fire. I go down, 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 flames get higher, and I burn, burn, burn. Your ring's on fire. Your ring's on fire. Hey! Love is sweet when hearts fall like ours beat. I fell for you like a child. Oh, boy, my wild. I fell into the burning ring of fire. I go down, down, down. Pennies get higher and burn, burn, burn. Your ring's on fire. Back to you.
In this institution, and
I pray. Oh my Lord, how I pray. Paint him a single day. And for a revolution. And so I cried sometimes when I'm lying in bed. I'm trying to get out of what's in my head. I feel a little peculiar. And so I wake up in the morning, step outside, take a deep breath, get real high, and I scream from the devil metal, what's going on? Come on! And I say, hey, hey. What's going on? And I say, hey, 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 hey. I say, hey, what's going on? Okay, so it's just, this is just for the girls, right? It's a competition now with boys and girls, right? It's a competition, right? All the girls. Okay, girls, you ready? Start the off right, girls only. That's it. Hey. Try again. Hey. Okay, just a guy. I said, hey, 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 I said, hey, what's going on? Come on, guys! And I said, hey, 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 I said, hey, what's going on? Sorry, but the guys won. I said, hey, hey. What's going on? 25 years I've been still. I'm trying to get up, great big hill of hope for a destination. Good night, God bless. Say one more hand, you guys are professionals.
That's Carol. You're the professionals, Carol.
Hey! Hello! Oh, well, listen, we let that one run because it was just good to hear Pat and playing some classics there. And that was what I meant to play a couple of weeks ago because it was his birthday a couple of weeks ago. But honestly, couldn't get it in the thing. But we've learned something else tonight. So we're getting better and better. Peter. You'll be away, you'll be watching no more in a couple of weeks. We'll have it all sorted. So, a couple of things that I wanted to say. First was that you'll see Gordon in Moira's Magic Moments. You'll have seen a really fantastic picture of Gordon in a hat. And which that was his wolf hat, his bearskin hat that when we first met Gordon. Used to see like drive past him at night, like this was really early on, because it never crossed my mind that Gordon would be walking home from the pub, but I would see him thinking he would be going for a taxi with his big bear hat on.
That isn't what you said. And, it is what's this called you in there?
Right, see, I'm supposed to be filling in whilst Mark looks for something, and then obviously, what film are you looking at?
Oh, hang on.
Are you on the wrong night?
No, in the wrong place.
Right, okay. So, and there was also, Gordon was playing Baran in one of the things, and I just wanted to say that he won't be watching because I don't think he has the internet, but for those of you who know, Gordon's, he's finally moved, and he's moving nearer the town, and hopefully, by the time we are all back out, Gordon will have moved to his forever home because he's getting a new place, and I'm really excited for him. And I mean, that's another good reason, isn't it, to be out in the world, because there's lots of people that we would just really like to spend time with. And Gordon, he's been coming, you know, since back in the Borough Field days. Has supported all the sessions. He loves his live music. He's also, which some of you maybe don't know, he's an absolutely brilliant cartoonist. He does some amazing, especially political cartoons. He's really good at those. And I have to try and see if I can get hold of some of his cartoons to show you. Anyway,
we're lined up.
Right, blimey.
Do you know what, Carol? I would really like to hear you sing now. That's what I'd like.
Would you, Mark? Is that what you'd like?
Yeah. In fact, I'd really like to hear you sing Autumn Leaves.
Oh, Mark, did you say you would really like to hear me sing?
Yeah, I'd really like to hear you sing, Carol.
Well, I would really like to hear you play guitar. Ooh. So, well, shall we do that?
Should we play this clip then, that I just happen to have lined up?
Yes, and now I actually, although this is from a night that we've already got loaded up, I actually really like this because it was me and Mark, but also with some extra help. And this song, I'm looking at my bloody camera again. Well, it is a beautiful song, and I actually remember the first time I heard this for real, as in its beauteousness, was we were in our old workshop back in Coventry, it's like an aircraft hangover barn that we had, and our workshop had first of all it had no walls, and then it had no roof, long story, but so we're in this quite a bizarre
in
room,
a field basically
in a field yeah. So
a car park,
yeah, anyway, but and this somebody gave us, I think it was it Mike, the guy who built his house, anyway, he brought in some CDs for us to listen to, and one of them was this woman called Eva Cassidy, and I'd never heard, and this song, I mean, don't do it quite the same as her, but this song stopped me in my tracks when I heard it. It made me breathless, and I'd heard the song before, but never heard it like this. So,
it's right up our street, isn't it?
Right up our street. But I wanted to play it tonight because this is for all of you that were watching, for all of you that we know. Well, I mean, for everybody, but for those of you that are regulars and we know well, this is for all of you because we do miss you.
There was a young maid of Madras who had the most beautiful ass.
Well, not, that was Ian Newlands.
Not rounded and pink as you probably think. It was grey, had long ears and ate grass.
Right, are you going to turn it on? Come on. I don't know what's going on down the end. They're singing. Right. So anyway, we were going to just finish there. We will try and squeeze a little bit of something in. Can I thank everybody that's played tonight? Thank you for our visitors. That was fantastic. Are you playing on Saturday? Right. So, if you would like to see them again, if you're watching at home, if you'd like to see them again, then they're playing at the Treehouse on Saturday, and which is very good, isn't it? I've just realised Canada is in the room. Isn't that weird? It's Meg from Canada. Suddenly, that's what we call her. She hasn't got any other name. She's just Meg from Canada. Thank you for coming. Are you alright, Meg? You alright? It's good to see. I've just interrupted.
happened last week. There were far too many beautiful reasons to be happy or something last week. The falling leaves drift past my window. The falling leaves are red.
Surprise! I don't know where to look.
Well, you said switch it about 5 seconds ago.
I know, but I was actually reading. Hello, Baird. Baird and Mona are having a chat online. I just love the internet when it's good. When it's good, it's blooming good, isn't it? And I would like an evening with proper drinks and snacks. I would like that, but it's not happening yet, is it? So, thank you to Duffy, Stevie, and that. Right. So you're gonna go back to the 22nd. Right. So, oh yeah, that just reminds me. I know what we've got to play next. So, yes. So we, obviously, Mark and I have been playing together for quite a long time, and what's quite nice though about what's very nice about Acoustic Bliss is that because also quite a lot of us now in different combinations have played together a whole variety of songs over a whole different period of time, and it's sort of, I don't know, it just, we can just play, people can jam and play, and it sounds, and I'm loving how good it sounds. And I know people have told us before that, you know, when they've got it plugged into their good speakers and they're on, they're watching it on HD, that the sound's really good. But when we're in it on a Thursday night, well, we just, you know, time flies and we're just loving the liveness of it. And although this isn't live, I tell you what, it's just hearing it and hearing the buzz and the people, it's the, it is the next best thing to be in there, really. A great night in, I reckon. So we're gonna carry on with that theme, really. Unbelievably, it's after 11. I can't get over that. It's 20 past. Yeah, and I'm just noticing Michelle's saying that that the feed is a bit behind, which is why they're not been chatting. We've noticed it's been lagging quite a bit, hasn't it? It was lagging quite a bit earlier. You just looked at me with vacant eyes. But hey, the interweb, we're lucky to have anything. We struggle with our broadband up here. You know, it's really, really bad. Really bad. And so bad that many people have told us that they would never live here. Because the internet's just that appalling. And just down the road in air, you know, like literally 3 miles away. I mean, we get like 1 meg or something, and down the road, you know, it's like 200 or something. So, yeah. And if you mention fibre and our postcode, they just literally laugh. So, Mark's lining up the next song, hopefully. I think he's trying to cut me talking off. Is that right? Yes. So we're going to play another song, and then I'm going to just look through my notes and remind myself of anything else that I need to say. But yeah, and do you know, it has been a nightmare getting everything ready, but actually John Bailey pointed out that Mark seemed a little less stressed tonight, and he has been, because actually, although we had all the problems before, mostly we had the problems before we came in tonight, and because I gave him numbers.
Yeah, the numbers help, Carol.
They did help.
And the numbers did help.
Next week it will just be,
we've run out of numbers now though, folks.
No, well, you've got the next, are you lined up?
Yeah, roughly.
Right, that's fine. So, well, let's play the next thing, and we've got a song or so. Oh, jeez. We've got a song or something.
Yeah. Lines. Are we ready?
I've stopped speaking. And if you put your mind to it, everything could happen. Anyway, we're going to play this. I love this song.
That you're not
they don't bother me. Here in my chair while you dance over me.
And you know what, folks? There are so many beautiful reasons to be happy, as my shirt said. Many.
No reverb on that, eh?
So tell them what you were moaning about.
I have to do the cameras, the sound and everything, and play the guitar. And I forgot to press the make it sound good button. Probably.
Poor lamb. Anyway, talking of lambs, right, we're going to have a slight interval now, right? We're almost at the end of our beautiful journey, folks. And Mark, he particularly is fond of this, but I want to introduce you, my friends, to you. You will remember Caroline, the lovely Caroline who worked behind the bar. And Caroline's gone on to, she is a tennis coach and she does tennis coaching for young people. And that's what she's doing. Well, that's what she was doing. And hopefully we'll all be allowed out before the summer's over and she'll be able to do it some more. But anyway, so Caroline is also at home and she has a thing now, and she's making, it's called Sparky TV. And so she's making videos to send to her students, I guess. But in amongst her tennis videos, there is this little gem. And so I want to show it to you. And then I'm hopefully Caroline's going to send me a video to explain all about Sparky TV. So here's a little taster. Here you go.
Yeah, enjoy this, folks.
Yay! Sparky!
Oh, well done, Sparky. Did you see that? I was really gobsmacked when the first time I saw that, because he was, you know, wiggling in and out, doing the slalom, and then he got the ball in this thing. That's fantastic. So,
that's all very well, but can he play guitar?
No. But,
so
I just
what's
wanted
he doing
to.
Here?
Well, because. You're so
mean. Can he sing?
He's very cute. He's big, though. I can't get over how big he is. He was much smaller the last time we saw him. Anyway.
Well, I really enjoyed that.
So thanks to Sparky TV.
So what are we going
to
do next? So
I've got... I live with a man who has no patience. He has no bloody cheer about him at all.
I love rabbits.
He doesn't like animals, children, blue skies, rainbows, unicorns. He doesn't like any of that. Anyway. So we are nearly at the end. Not quite, though. We haven't finished with you yet. And
I've not had my instructions.
You had them, but you were too busy moaning to notice them. So,
forgotten.
So it's the last video that's easy to line up.
Oh,
it?
We're going for the finale. The finale.
Don't spoil everything.
I'm allowed to say the finale, aren't I?
Well, it's kind of, yes.
It's the finale. It's the last one. Last one, folks. I ain't going to brush my hair either. Until the apocalypse
is over. Have you put your head down?
No.
Look.
What?
It's going...
What? I'm going to put my head down and watch it back later, because I can't see.
It's grey. Oh, look. Look.
Do it really fast, I might see.
I thought you'd been painting or something this morning when I saw you from that. But anyway, sorry. So
time for a crew cut.
Well, if he does that, we're doing it live.
No one will recognise me.
On a Thursday, we're going to do it live.
You won't know who I am, will you?
I think they
if
will.
If I have a crew cut.
They will. Look, you've got it tucked behind. Anyway, look, we're not here to talk about his hair.
Not happening. It's not happening.
Stop this. So, now, one of the things... Right, so I have to apologise. Ruth recommends. Now, she recommends Damon McFly, right? And he was going to send me a video, and he hasn't yet. So... Ruth recommends Damon McFly's live stream. It's on a Wednesday. Also, Connor Johnson has a live stream on a Wednesday. Ruth didn't recommend that. I'm just recommending that. But hopefully next week we will have Damon McFly, and that will be a Ruth recommends thing. And we'll get the Chloe's choices, and you know, it'll all be good by then. So I would also every week like to take you to my happy place. And so for the last couple of weeks, I've managed to find a video. Well, not managed. There has been videos that take me to my happy place. Now, this one reminds me of lots of things. And one of the things I like about Bliss is thinking, oh, it would be good if that person played with that person, and getting them up despite their protestations. I like that because sometimes, you know, usually is beautiful stuff comes out, and moments are created. But also the people in this next clip, in our sort of finale, if you like. So it's my happy place for the finale. It's everything about it. Lots of memories, lots of people. It was a really busy night in March, a few years ago, and it was just such a there was a fab atmosphere, and great music, and these guys had never played together before, and I just love it. So enjoy.
Singing the blues. Thank you. singing the blues. Oh baby, I came tonight. Oh, I came singing the blues. Oh please, baby, I wanna see you just one more time.
Expecting that.
Ancora! Ancora!
I'm not a Nico, don't use that
name. No, it's a bad joke, I tell you.
Bad joke.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh God, what?
Sweet home Chicago.